How does Santa know if you're good or bad? Does he call or text your mom or dad? Is he watching you both day and night? Does he follow you close and not let you out of sight? No, Santa has help to keep an eye on you. He assigns an elf to each family to see all they do. I'll be watching to see if you follow and obey the rules and things your parents have to say. I'll keep track of each deed, yep, every single one. It's my job to tell Santa the things you have done. So each night I use my magic to fly to the North Pole. Nice kids get presents, naughty ones get coal. After I deliver my report to St. Nick, I get back to your house super fast and right quick. Every morning you must try and find me in whatever hiding place I might be. Before my job starts, there are two rules you must know. First, subscribe to Jack Jack or I lose my magic and must go. Second, leave a comment, but it must come from the heart. Write something special and my magic will start. Remember to be good and spread holiday cheer. Have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Hey guys, it's Jack Jack and welcome back to my channel. I found that little poem on Google. I'll leave it linked below if you guys want to see it. Of course, I had to add my little Jack Jack twist to it. But anyways, I'm so excited for this tutorial. So let's get started by first blocking out our brows. But don't worry, I have a detailed tutorial for you guys. So we're going to skip that in this video. But if you want to learn how to block your brows, definitely check out that video. So here we go. No eyebrows. Definitely feeling very alien-like with no eyebrows and my shaved head. So yeah, we're looking like a masterpiece right now. So anyways, starting with the actual makeup part of this look, I'm going to start by priming my face. This is the Lala Fox Air Primer. And then for foundation, I'm using my favorite full coverage foundation. This is the Too Faced Peach Perfect foundation. And ignore my sponge. It has orange on the bottom and that's what I used to do my eyebrows. Yes, you have to use orange to block out your brows, but you'll hear more about that if you go and watch that tutorial that I did. I did that 2 years ago, a year ago, last year I made that tutorial. So go check that out if you want to learn how to properly block your eyebrows without shaving. Once the foundation is done, we can move on to concealer, and I'm going to take the Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Use Sculpting Concealer, and I'm going to heavily apply this onto my under eye and cheek area because I want to cover up all of my freckles. We want to look like a doll, so I want my skin to look like plastic, so I'm going really full coverage. And to blend all of that out, I'm just taking the same sponge, and I'm just going to press it into my skin until everything is nice and blended. And now to set everything, I'm using the Too Faced Born This Way Translucent Powder, and I'm going to just take some of that and use my same sponge and apply that all over my face. I'm just pressing it into the cream products to lock it and set it into place, and I am using quite a lot, but I'm not baking. Baking, I would just let it sit there like this for a little bit, but I'm just pressing all of it until it kind of just disappears and blends into the skin. So I'm just pressing my sponge into my skin until all of the powder has kind of disappeared on my skin. And I want to set around my nose. I really want my skin to look as like doll-like and plastic as possible. So I'm going hardcore with the setting powder. Now I'm going in with this Pop Beauty Contour 101 palette. This is the matte version. I'm going to take these two shades, a little more of the Sculpt shade, which is the more cool tone, but I'm doing a mixture of both, and I'm going to blend that into my crease to add some slight definition to my eyes. And see this brush that I'm using? It's full size right now, but you're going to see later on in this video, it's going to break and become a mini version in a second. And I'm also going to take those same colors and the same brush and start contouring the sides of my nose so that our nose looks really small and petite, like a little doll. Do you hear Zoe's little footsteps? Go ahead, lay down, Zoe. Lay down. Sorry about that. I just can't help but get so distracted by her. And I'm also going to round out the tip of my nose. So I'm basically creating a circle just on the tip of my nose, and that's going to give us a cute little button type of nose. And here we go with the brush. It broke. Ooh, I'm so sad because this brush is actually pretty good. But I'm going to keep using it. We're still going to make it work. And I'm going to go ahead and deepen up the contour on the nose. Just creating that shadow is going to give the appearance of a taller nose bridge. And then same with like the button shape that we created on the tip of the nose. And because I want my eyes to appear big, I'm going to basically, you probably can't see this, but where my eyebrows are, like my natural eyebrows, I am bringing the contour color that we're working with up towards my natural eyebrows, trying to make it seem like that is my crease of my eye. I tried. So just blending that out, and then I'm going to take a brown face paint and I'm going to go ahead and draw on my eyebrows. And if you look at the Elf on the Shelf doll, the eyebrows are kind of far apart, like super far apart like this, and it's because his hair kind of goes in the middle of the eyebrows, so I wanted to make sure I left enough space so that I can draw his hair on my forehead. So with that brown face paint, I'm just deepening and darkening the eyebrows, but they're just two little parentheses lines like this. So now would probably be a good time to go ahead and throw on our little Santa hat, so that way we can mark out exactly where we want our fake doll hair to be. So I'm using the same brown that I used for my eyebrows, and I'm gonna go ahead and start tracing out the shape of the hair. It's good if you have like a reference picture. There's so many different type of elves, like Elf on the Shelf dolls that you can find online, but for the most part it has this kind of like swoopy bang thing in the center of the head, so that's what I tried to copy. And then I wanted to have some hair on the side, kind of like the little sideburns, or like just the pieces of the hair that are peeking through on the sides, so that's what I'm drawing here as well. And I mean, it looks funky right now, but this is just kind of the outline that we're creating. And if you mess up, it's okay. It's not the end of the world. It's just makeup. We can wipe it off, we can cover it up, and we can fix it. So I drew this one a little bit weird. So I'm just taking a little bit of foundation on my beauty sponge to cover that up, and we're going to try again. So once we have this shape down, I'm just going to speed through, and we're going to fill it all in with that same brown color. So once we have that done, I'm going to move back over to the eyes, and I'm going to take a little bit of this white face paint, and I'm just going to draw and extend the whites under my eyes. So like this is kind of my new waterline. This is going to give us that big doll-like look. Not that like the Elf on the Shelf has like super gigantic eyes, but this gives our human feature a more doll-like appearance. Now going back into those contour shades that we were using earlier, I'm just going to pinch my blending brush and sweep this right under the white area. And this is a subtle detail, but if you look closely, you can see that it adds a little bit of shadow and kind of just rounds out the eyes to make it look a little bit more realistic. It's a subtle detail, yes, so you might not be able to tell, but it's just like one of those tiny details that really just brings this look together. I'm going to take my Stila Feltip liner, my Stay All Day Micro Tip Liner, I think that's what this one is called, and I'm just going to slightly line my eyes. And this might be hard to see, but where the white face paint that we applied under our waterline earlier, I'm going to extend the black liquid liner out to the distance and like the length of the white, if that makes sense. So our eyeliner is going a little bit past our eye. And now for mascara, I'm just applying it to my top lashes, and then we can move on to falsies. So I'm using some long wispy lashes from Bold Face Makeup, and I'm just going to apply those onto my eyes like so. If you want a detailed tutorial on how to apply lashes, I'll leave one linked in the cards for you guys. And to really enhance this doll-like look, I'm going to add falsies onto my lower lash line. When you do add falsies to your lower lash line like this, you want to make sure that they are a little more on the natural side. So just a little tip. And now I'm taking a black face paint to outline our hair, and I'm also going to add some little detail marks in there as well, just to make the hair look more cartoony. For blush, I'm going into the Too Faced Sugar Peach Face and Eye Palette. I'm taking the color Sugared Peach, and I'm going to pack that on in kind of a circular motion like this, so we have nice rosy cheeks just like a doll. And then for the lips, I'm going to take one of my favorite nudes, which is from Kylie Cosmetics. This is the Kylie Lip Kit in Exposed, and I'm going to use the lip liner that comes in the kit to fill in and line my lips, and then I'm going to go over it with the liquid lipstick, and then that is it for this makeup look. And then we can move on to painting on our clothes. Yeah, we're gonna paint on our clothes right now. So I used a white eyeliner to just sketch out the design on my like décolleté chest area. And it was actually pretty simple. It's just like kind of these zigzags for the collar part and then the rest is just red. So it was actually really easy to do. So you wanna start off by painting the white part first. And this can be a little messy because you can define everything once you go over, like once you fill in the design with the red, you can kind of clean up the edges. So I'm just messily applying the white for the like spiky collar that the elf has. And then afterwards, we can go ahead and fill it in with a red face paint. And it was kind of hard to show you, like me painting the red part, so I'm just going to skip ahead to the finished look. So that is it for my Elf on the Shelf inspired makeup tutorial. I had so much fun doing this. I love how the look turned out. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know in the comments, does the Elf on the Shelf visit your guys' home during the holidays? Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!